What's up, guys? I told you I'd make a shelter video today. It's like 12:37. I don't have the shelter done today because I ran out of logs I need. And yeah, so this is what I got done for today. I might work on it some more, but this is what I'm showing you now. It's part one of the A-frame shelter. So here we go. Alright, so I did the basic two support beams, which are logs with Y shapes in them. I drove them to the ground. I have an angle support here and an angle support on the other side, like over here, so it won't shake anywhere. And I put a big ridge pole on there. The ridge pole is probably 2.5 inches thick. I got like almost half of the first covering of sticks on it, like these parts. There's the other support beam. I just ran out of logs. My log pile was over there. I had like maybe, I don't know, 15. But I got about 8 logs on the side, on each side, and that's the bed. That's a log for my bed I'm gonna be making, and I might make a fireplace like right over here somewhere. There's a creek over there, a log that you take a bridge over there. It's a natural bridge, just an old tree that fell. Here's the creek, right here. Here's an old bridge that I made out of logs. We used most of the logs from that. And, I got bored with making that for today, so I started on the bridge to get on the other side for trees, which are over there. All those trees and stuff I'm gonna cut down and use for logs. Well, in the meantime, I used the rest of the logs that I didn't, they were too big for that, and made a bridge. As you can see. It's all natural except for that pallet, and there's two by fours over there. But there's all old wood, it's not new or anything, so I found it in there in the creek. I started it with just regular logs, like right here, but it was too sketchy, because I slipped and fell through. There's 5 big, huge ones that go that way across. Yeah, I'll show you the demonstration of walking across. It's pretty sketchy. Let's see if I can do a first-person thing. Aha! I'm gonna have to hold it so it's. Doesn't shake. So here's about the pallet right here. As you can see, it's kind of sketchy. This is the sketchiest part, because that 2x4 right there, teeter-totters like this. So yeah, you have to lean your foot back a little bit. This is the sketchiest part. And then I usually just skip this log and go to this one and step up. Now we're on the other side. So yeah, my other shelter, the one you saw in that last series, you go from where the shelter is there, you go and walk this way and go around that hill over there. And you're to the other one. It's about, I don't know, maybe 1/2 mile from here. Not even that, probably. But yes, it is spring, April 1st, I think. Yep, April 1st. And, here's the time and stuff if you guys are really curious. 12:42. If you guys like these vlog series, I'm not much of a vlogger. I mean, you know what's funny is, I watch a shit ton of vloggers off of YouTube, like Roman Atwood, let's see, FusyTube, Casey Neistat, who else? Tyler Monaghan, he's like a motor vlogger. He does vlogs and also rides dirt bikes and races them. There's a whole bunch of people I like that are vloggers. I mostly watch vlogs now. I'm gonna start my own vlogging series like this right now. I have to get used to having the camera pointed at me. It's kind of weird, but yeah. Like I said last night, or technically today, but it was like at 3 a.m. I will make a knife collection and survival bag video eventually. Pretty soon, about 2 months from now, I might take this camera and you guys with me down to Florida. Now you're gonna be like, what? Whoa, why are you moving to Florida, Eli? I am, but May 31st is when I get out of school for summer break. Sorry, I say a lot, that's kind of weird, but I just noticed that. Anyways, whenever spring break hits, May 31st, I'm gonna be, my grandma and grandpa, they just moved down to Florida like a month ago. They're gonna be coming down to pick me up, and I have to do some work for them, and I'll get to see their apartment, and hopefully their house now. So, yeah, I'll be down there for most of the summer. Spring break is actually, you have this weekend, the week coming up after this weekend, which is after Sunday. And then after that week's over with school, we have 5 days for spring break. I'm going down to Kentucky with Ian Trickett. Check out his channel, Ian Trickett. Subscribe to him if you can. But we're going down to Kentucky for spring break, and we're going to make shit ton of porn. Or not. A shit ton of riding videos, like trail riding and everything. He said there's like a trail that can go like 9 miles, and if I can get a helmet that has padding in it, like my most recent video you saw, the helmet I got doesn't have any padding and it's an older model. The facial thing that comes out of your mouth screws on, so that, if that tells you anything, it's pretty old. I'm gonna get a helmet eventually and a dirt bike. And I'm going to start maybe racing after I get my mechanics degree. I'm going to go to college, get a mechanic degree, and then go to MIT and get a motorcycle mechanic degree so I can work on any bike. And, yeah, then I'm going to get my motorcycle license and all that fun stuff. I'm going to be probably riding the 110 in Kentucky. And Ian's what? I feel like I can't ride because Ian is almost 13, I'm 16. He can ride a YZ85, and I'm only on the 110, which is an automatic. His is clutch. Well, the truth is, I've never ridden a dirt bike with a clutch or an ATV with a clutch. I've never driven anything that had a clutch. I know the basics of driving a clutch, and I know how to do it. I just have never actually done it, if that makes sense. So, when I get a dirt bike, I'm going to get probably a 125 or 150 and learn how to do a clutch. And I'll make a lot of videos doing that. Probably make some racing videos later on, way down in the timeline. But for now, we have spring break coming up for videos. We have summer break for videos coming up. So I should put out maybe 10 videos each. I work on videos now because I kind of like this. Anyways, let's see what else is there to talk about. What else? Beatboxing videos. I really don't do beatboxing anymore, honestly. And if I do, it's for fun. So that's why I'm pretty crappy. But I just never really tried my best to do beatboxing. So it's kind of like a fun thing to do. I made a rap lyric sheet. It's been done for a couple weeks now. I just need to find some music for it. And I'm gonna put that on. It's actually better than the last one. The last one was pretty crappy. But yeah, I think that's about it. So, yeah, I've been just down here by myself in the woods, making that shelter. Over there, can you see it? Yeah, over there, making that bridge, and listening to some music on my Midland. Hold on, I gotta get a fish first, then I go. I gotta cross this sketchy. This bridge is really bad, like, I mean, it's not bad, it's just, like, really sketchy, if that makes sense. It's not, like, I like it, but I need to work on it more. Alright, here we go, first person again. Alright, first one down, second, haha, got it. Alright, back to basically still first person, but anyways, there's my sheath, you can see it better in the daylight. There's my survival bag, and my bat, my, I have an emergency radio, listen to music on, it's a Midland, and, that antenna is not actually the antenna for it, the antenna snapped on it, so that's actually my RC, antenna. And it has a light, a flashlight, it's really bright, like, when I was at my other shelter with the tarps on it, I could, like, halfway down the trail, I could flash it all over to those trees over there, and I can see, like, pretty far, at least 800 feet, maybe. It has a dim and bright setting, it takes a battery as a power source, and solar, and also, you can charge it with emergency battery packs, whatever you call them. It has a emergency weather broadcast. Select, like, you can choose different emergency channels and stuff. I have a bunch of leaves in here for some reason. Anyways, yeah. We got a little stash of tools over here. After this, I'll let you guys go. I'm running out of, things to say. Man, it's already 12 minutes. Holy crap. Anyways, over here we stash our tools sometimes. And right now we have a shovel. Can you see that? I can't really see it on camera. We have a shovel. And a bungee cord. I don't know why that's down here, but, yeah. And here's that log. Anyways, here we go. Little waterfall there. And yeah. I don't know, a pretty decent height. I would say, I don't know, 5, maybe 6 feet high. Well, 6.5 technically because of how thick the log is. But I can stand underneath of it. And out there is my shelter. But yeah, that's pretty much what I got for today. If I work on the shelter anymore, I'll let you guys know by getting the camera back out. But yeah, if you guys like this video for today, about the shelter series, I'm starting another one. This is part one of the A-frame and bridge shelter. What else? Oh, if you guys like this video, please comment a positive message below, hit the like button, and subscribe if you really want to. I'm not gonna pressure you to do it, but it's your choice to subscribe or not. If you really like our channel, then please do so. It helps out a lot. Anyways, my name is Larry Mercy, or EMP Beast, which I don't really use that name anymore, but